start by looking the meaning of the term algebra. What do we mean when we are talking about the algebra? So, simply, when we are talking about the algebra, this is the branch of basic mathematics which use letters to represent numbers. So, what we are going to do in this topic is how we can use the letters to represent numbers. So that is what we mean when we are talking about algebra. As we saw from numbers, that we can add them, we can subtract them, we can divide them, also we can multiply them. As well in letters, we shall see how we can add, how we can subtract, how we can multiply, and how also we can divide them. For example, we can take any plus any, which is the same as n times 2, which is equals to 2n. Now you can see, we have added the letters as we did in numbers. Also, we can take m plus m plus m, which is equals to m times 3, which gives us 3m. Also here we have added the letters as we did in numbers there. The same x plus x plus x plus x, which is equals to x times 4, which gives us 4x. So that is what we can do on letters as we did in numbers. So, my dear student, that is the general concept of what we mean when we are talking about algebra. Now, after getting the general concept on this, let me start on looking the subtopics of our topic. And we shall start by looking the first subtopic known as algebraic expression. What do we mean when we are talking about algebraic expression? Algebraic expression, this is just the collection of numbers, variables, and operations. So this is just a group of those three terms: numbers, variables, and the operation. When those three terms joined together, they give us what we call algebraic expression. So algebraic expression is obtained after combining numbers, variables, and the operation. For example, we have x plus 2. Also, we have 3y plus 5. Also, we have 3a plus 2n. Those are some examples of algebraic expression. As you can see them, it's a collection of numbers, operation, and this is variables. So that is what we mean when we are talking about the algebraic expression. Now, after getting the meaning of algebraic expression, let me come to some terms which are commonly used in algebraic expression. We have different terms which we are supposed to know, and it's very important to know them. So we shall start looking one term after another. The first term which we are supposed to know is known as variables. What is variables? Variables are the letters used to represent one or more numbers. Any letter in expression is known as variable. Is there to represent one or more number. That's why it's called the variables. For example, in 3y plus 5, this y is a letter. So this y is called a variable. And it's here to represent a certain numbers. That is what we mean when we are talking about variables. Let me move to the second term. The second term is known as constant. Constant. Constant, this is a number in an expression. Is a number in an expression, but with no variable. A number in an expression without a variable is what we call a constant. For example, in 3y plus 5, this 3 has a variable. So this 3 is not a constant, but this 5 has no variable. So this 5 is called a constant. That is what we mean when we are talking about the constant. Let me come to the third term. A third term is known as coefficient. We saw from constant there, that is a number with no variable. In other words, we have this number with a variable. This number with a variable is what we call constant, which is multiplied by a variable. So, by the definition, constant is a constant multiple of a variable. Or, a number which multiplied by a variable. That is what we call a constant. For example, in this expression, we have 3. This 3 means is multiplied by a. So this 3 is what we call a coefficient, as a number multiplied by a variable. Also, this 2 is multiplied by n. So this 2 is a coefficient of variable n. So we can conclude by saying 3 and 2 are coefficients of a and n. That is what we mean when we are talking about the coefficient. And the last term we are supposed to know is known as terms. Terms. What do we mean when we are talking about terms? Terms are the parts of expression. Are the parts. In other words, we can say are the components. Components of expression. For example, in 5a plus 2n minus 3a plus 7n, all those parts are what we call terms. So 5a, 2n, 3a, and 7n are the terms of this expression, or are the components of this expression. In terms, you are supposed to note the following. That in this expression, we have two types of terms. The first type is like terms. The terms having the same variable. For instance, 5 has a and 3 has a also. So 5 and a are the like terms. 2 has any, and 7 has any. So also 2 and 7 are the like terms. The second type of term is unlike term. Unlike term are the terms having different variables. For instance, 5 has A as its variable, but 2 has N as its variable. So 5 and 2 are the two different terms, known as unlike terms. Dear students, after looking those terms which are commonly used in algebraic expression, let me see how we can simplify the algebraic expression. And in simplifying algebraic expression, we shall start by looking how we can simplify the expressions by using addition and subtraction. So we said addition and subtraction can be used to simplify the expression. We can use those two operations to simplify algebraic expression. When we are using addition and subtraction to simplify the expression, we only add or subtract the coefficient of the same of the like terms. You must note this. When you are simplifying the expression by using addition or subtraction, make sure you add the coefficients of the like terms. For example, it's possible to simplify 5a plus 5a to get 10a. How do we get this 10? Is by adding the coefficient of a, which is 5, and this coefficient of a, which is 5, since are the like terms. So it's possible to take 5 plus 5 is 10 to get 10a. Also, we can simplify this by taking 5 plus 4 to get 9 minus 2, we get 7a. So when we are simplifying by addition or subtraction, consider the coefficients of the like terms. Remember this, it is not possible to simplify unlike terms. It is never possible to simplify unlike terms. For example, 3a minus 3n. This cannot be simplified since those two terms are unlike. So this will remain as it is, as 3a minus 3n. Also, 2a plus 5. It cannot be simplified since the two terms are unlike. So this will remain as 2a plus 5. So that is what you are supposed to know when we are simplifying the algebraic expression just by using addition and subtraction. Thank you. And for today, let we only end here. We shall continue next time. Thank you very much.